good morning. I'm so sorry to bop over here so early, but Brenda, duty calls. I need you back on the Jax for Men tour ASAP.
Get me results. Major drug action leaves trails. You find them, you follow them.
Maybe this is a good time to give you this. It's an address.
Oh, I can see that. Who from?
Well, I don't know the guy's name, but I saw him late last night, and he was pushing the hard stuff like he was giving away candy from a doctor's office. Took a little care, but I stayed behind him long enough to follow him home.
What the hell you think you're doing, Mike?
Trying to help. Getting you some information.
I have people I pay to do that.
Yeah, but they haven't come up with zip. Look, it happens that I was at the right place at the right time.
Yeah, that was the right time for you to get out of there. This isn't some go-kart a kid needs his dad's help with, Mike. Stay out of it!
I assume this is your subtle way of saying to me that you don't want me to take a slug for you again. Thanks, son.
It's a really bad time.
You are absolutely right. It's a horrible time. It's because we're so late. That's because you took all that time off. Don't you remember the He'll Never Forget You campaign? That was for our holiday sales. And those holidays are rapidly approaching. Brenda, I made a lot of deals, a lot of promises.
Lucy, I understand what you're saying. I just need to know if you understand that Jax and I still have a lot of things we need to work out.
No. No, actually, I don't. See, I really don't get what the big deal is. What do you have to work out? I mean, so what? Your dead wife suddenly shows up. It did throw everybody for a bit of a loop. I guess it threw the two of you sort of for a real loop. But look at you two. You're still here. You're still together. So you're still married, right?
Well, I'm sure you can appreciate this is a complex situation. That's why I have to see Miranda as soon as possible.
Great. Is that a problem?
Why would that be a problem?
No, it's... I called her last night and, excuse me. Yes? Beg your pardon? No.
Psst. Brenda, I don't mean to pry, but see, if Jax and Miranda are still married, that means you and Jax aren't still married. But it seems to me it's just a matter of legality, right? I mean, it can be fixed, right?
Life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Right. So?
I'm gonna have to get back to you on this.
Okay, so could maybe life let you know when soon, huh?
Lucy, I'm sorry. But that's really the best I can do right now. Jax is going through a really terrible time, and I'm sure that you understand why I can't leave him.
Yeah, I'm afraid so, I can. You see, this is the problem, though, when you have a business life and you want to have friends, too, because you can't have your business and have your friends, you lose one or the other, and I'm sorry. I had no idea that it was just so complicated for the two of you.
Yeah. I guess things are kind of complicated for you, too, huh? How is Kevin?
Kevin is a beautiful, confused person.
Ah, what a coincidence.
Yeah. Hey, you know what? For me, sometimes it does help to just get away a bit. You know, get some perspective on it. But I am absolutely not going to push you into anything because I will respect whatever you want to do and I will cope because I've gotten very, very good lately at learning to cope.
Huh, maybe you could give me lessons.
Just call me, okay? Soonest, you promise?
You'll be at the office?
Yeah, for a while, and then I have to meet Kevin at the hospital to go... Never mind. Just call me.
I will. And thank you for being patient.
You're welcome. What are friends for? Ta.
I'm sorry, that is just unacceptable. Okay? I have to go.
Is everything okay?
No.
When have you seen Miranda?
Don't you know? I mean, I heard you pick up the extension last night.
I didn't hear you set a time.
Well, that's because I got off when I realized you weren't planning on hanging up. I didn't want Miranda to know that you were listening.
Well, who were you protecting, me or her?
I was trying for both.
Well, no wonder you're exhausted.
I was going to tell you about the call, you know.
Well, I was going to tell you that I was listening. Probably. Well, I waited in bed all night long to tell you. Do you know what I remembered? When we were in New Orleans, that fortune teller told us that someone that we least expected was going to turn out to be Two-Faced. Who knew she meant literally?
Maybe she meant me. Look, when you're torn in two, you wind up looking in both directions. Look, I hate what this is doing to you, Brenda. And I know I'm making it harder. But I can't allow Miranda to be hurt anymore by anyone.
I'm sure that's the place.
Bumble, what's this?
It's even got the same initials. Long whiskers. Yeah, there's a rock face in the mountains between here and Rochester. We studied it in science in eighth grade or something. The rock looks like an old man with a beard.
And they call him Long Whiskers. Okay.
This is Timoria?
The radio tower wasn't exactly in Port Charles either. But Long Whiskers is even farther away.
And the trail leads out of town.
So maybe we should be looking close to home.
So in other words, Long Whiskers could also be known as Red Herring.
Right, could be. You know, maybe this whole thing is to get the Spencers on a wild goose chase while they slip Helena in the back door.
You think the old lady's here?
It's possible.
Where?
I don't know. But there's one place so obvious we wouldn't think to look. I'll check it out.
Hey, be careful, Dad.
Hey, you too. Keep an eye on him.
I'll call you. So, I mean, what about the landmarks you've already hit? Any clues?
There's nothing. I don't know how to figure it out. I mean, I don't know what they want.
Well, why don't you make a list of them? Maybe something will jump up and hit one of us.
Might as well do something. All right.
Did you have a chance to look at that info I gave you earlier?
Yeah, I did. That's all you need to know. Last thing I need is somebody on the outside taken down.
Inside, outside? Who draws those lines, Sonny? Who decides who does and doesn't get hurt?
Oh, so glad to see you. I need a friend.
What's that?
Basically just more of the same, except worse. You know, I was telling you that Jax was so concerned about his father's condition and all the lies that he told him and everything, that Miranda was just a minor player.
You did, and you didn't buy it any more than I did.
Yeah. Well, I'm not in denial anymore. I'm scared. Jax is really frantic with guilt over her, and he's asked her to stay here. And, you know, I have no idea what I'm dealing with here. He wouldn't tell me anything about them or the way they were together. So I found out that he wrote her some letters, and I went into her room and I read them.
And what did they tell you?
Everything I didn't want to know. That he was madly in love with her. That they were like soulmates and he wanted to spend the rest of his life with her.
But that was who they were then.
I know, and this is now, and I'm trying to remind myself of that. Right now, he wants to be with me. He loves me.
And he's told you that?
Yeah. Over and over. What is happening? You know, we were already married. This whole thing was supposed to be just for show. I'd only just realized how much I really love him. And now everything I do seems to make him angry. And protective of her. And then I ask him for reassurance and then he gives it to me. And it just rings hollow. And I keep on trying to do things to bring us closer together, and I feel like every single thing I do is just making us farther apart. Things were so good between us. Sorry, I'm babbling.
That's okay. If it helps.
I think it does.
And keep going. I'm listening. Yeah, this is Jax calling from Miranda. Miranda, if you're there, please pick up. Listen, I can't wait much longer. There's things that we need to resolve for both our sakes. Miranda? Listen, Mac, if you play this before she does, please let her know that I called. Thanks.
All right, here's the deal. I want you to watch this creep as long as you can. But do not, and I'm going to repeat this, Jason, do not rush in there. All right? See you later.
Sonny.
What?
Got a minute?
Yeah, Ned, what's on your mind?
Australia. And in particular, a little town called Cooper's Ridge.